What's up, guys? Welcome to the Microjig Shop. My name's Morgan, and today we're going to be taking an in-depth look at the MATCHFIT system. We'll explore the theory behind it, how that plays into the design of each product, and hopefully that'll give you a better understanding of how the MATCHFIT system can help you work smarter in your workshop. MATCHFIT, what's that even mean? Great question. Thanks for asking. The MATCHFIT system is based around the proven reliability of the Dovetail profile. We've leveraged the versatility of the Dovetail profile not for joinery, but as a complete work holding solution for your entire workshop. Dovetail clamps. Dovetail clamps were the first product in the MATCHFIT line. It was designed around a half-inch, 14-degree dovetail profile because it's steadily been the most common dovetail router bit on the market. The jaw of the clamp is forged to match this profile so that it can fit into the track created by this router bit. See what I did there? The dovetail profile makes it possible to clamp material where traditional clamps just can't go. By having the ability to create your own tracks on the fly, we've eliminated the need to buy and install expensive metal T-track. This allows you to add essential functionality to virtually any surface in your workshop. Why Dovetail? Thought you'd never ask. In addition to its popularity and availability, the physical attributes that make Dovetail joints strong and reliable also make it an ideal profile for tracks. If we used a T-slot profile, all the clamping pressure would be concentrated on these two small lips with the force pulling perpendicular to the surface. This lends itself to weakness as pressure is applied, especially if the T-slots are in plywood with the contact points located where two thin plies meet. The tapered walls of the MATCHFIT dovetail track create a broader contact surface with the jaw of the clamp and distribute clamping pressure evenly and non-perpendicular to the surface of the material. This creates a stronger track for assembly and all kinds of work holding solutions. Is a wood track strong enough? Won't the clamp just tear out? I actually get this question a lot. So when you're clamping material, force is applied concurrently. Meaning, as you tighten the clamp, the jaw is pulled up while an equal amount of pressure is applied downward. So the force isn't actually pulling, it's pinching. Now let's look at that in contrast with aluminum T-track. To install T-track, you still have to route out a channel so that it sits flush with the surface of the material. Standard T-track has a standard interior depth of 3/8 of an inch, leaving very little material to secure the track in place. That means you have to use very small screws. When pressure is applied anywhere but directly over the track, the track would remain intact, however the small screws holding it in place could easily tear out. Not to mention, aluminum T-track on average costs about $7 a linear foot. So there's that. Can I do the same thing with dog holes? In some cases yes, in others no. For instance, let's say you want to secure material on a table saw sled or at a tall fence. You wouldn't be able to just stick any old F-style clamp in a dog hole without the jaw sticking out of the other side. Not only that, dog holes can find the clamp to a fixed location, which may not work for the workpiece you're trying to secure. Dovetail tracks allow the clamp to move anywhere along the track, remaining inside the material so no part of the clamp interferes with your work. Sure, dog holes do just fine holding things down on a workbench, but only with clamps. What about hardware? Only tracks give you the ability to use hardware to secure jigs anywhere on your work surface. Dovetail clamps have a throat depth of 2 3/8 of an inch and a clamping capacity of 5 3/8 of an inch, applying 595 pounds of clamping pressure with a removable machine screw that allows you to reverse the arm of the clamp. Dovetail hardware. MATCHFIT dovetail hardware was created for use in jigs and fixtures and replaces traditional metal hardware for T-track. Hardware made for aluminum T-track comes in all shapes and sizes, which can be frustrating when you're trying to find the right hardware to match it. By standardizing our hardware with the same half-inch, 14-degree dovetail profile as our clamps, everything works together in one standard track. We currently offer three types of hardware: 1.5-inch long with wing knobs, 1-inch long with round knobs and nylon shoulder washers, and female with 10/32 threaded inserts, screws, and washers. The 1.5-inch long hardware and wing knobs are ideal for jigs made out of thicker material. The wing knobs give you more torque for applications that call for a tighter hold. The 1-inch long hardware works really well in tighter spaces where you might not have enough clearance to turn a wing knob. The included shoulder washers are compatible with the accessory notches found throughout the GRR-RIPPER line of products. The female track nuts allow you to use any length of 10/32 screw to secure jigs and fixtures with a flat surface. One notable feature of the dovetail hardware is this subtle ramp at the bottom. Sometimes when you're out a lot of tracks, the depth can be inconsistent. This becomes a problem where two tracks intersect. If the depth of the tracks don't match, you'll end up with steps that could bind up the hardware. The ramp lets hardware pass over those small steps with ease. When using dovetail hardware in a grid of intersecting tracks, you can cut slots in your jig that allows you to rotate it 360 degrees. This isn't necessarily a new concept, but historically this would need to be done with intersecting T-track. Installing T-track intersections is tedious and expensive, whereas with the MATCHFIT system you can create your own grid of tracks with just a router bit. Dovetail router bit. The MATCHFIT system was designed around a standard half-inch 14-degree dovetail profile. Although this bit from any manufacturer will work, we made some improvements to the profile and started making our own. One key feature of our dovetail router bit is the built-in roundovers. We added a 1/16 inch radius to the top because a regular dovetail bit, although perfect for joinery, wasn't ideal for creating clamp tracks. The tapered profile cuts to a sharp point, and even a brand new super sharp bit will leave behind fibers that need to be sanded off. So if you're routing a bunch of tracks, that'll eat up a lot of valuable shop time. Not only does it eliminate the need for sanding, it removes sharp edges that could potentially bind up material sliding across the top. You'll notice that the top radius doesn't completely round off. What this does is create a 30/1000ths of an inch depth tolerance, so the narrowest part of the track will remain constant. Because it doesn't completely round off, you avoid creating a step where a normal radius would end. We call this flare edge technology. There's also a 1/32nd inch roundover at the bottom to strengthen the track structurally by removing less material. Dado stop. The Dado stop makes fast, incredibly accurate crosscut dados with a standard saw blade without the need for a stacked dado set. The theory behind the Dado stop is to set the width of the dado cut by registering off of the width of the material while simultaneously accounting for the exact curve of the blade. This eliminates the need to install a stacked dado set and experiment with a bunch of shims. Simply template the blade's kerf, either with a setup gauge or with a scrap piece of MDF. Once you have a template of your kerf, you set leg number 2. With leg number 2 set to account for the blade's kerf, leg number 3 is set to the width of the inlay material. Just use a setup gauge or a simple square. You'll notice a gap between the square and leg number 1. This is your kerf. When you cut one side of the dado, the blade will remove material equal to the width of that gap. Make your first cut by registering off leg number 1, your second cut by registering off leg number 3. Then clear the waste out of the middle in a few passes. This is great for cutting lap joints or decorative inlays. The Dado stop is also very helpful for calibrating your fence scale. The fixed leg number 1 is exactly 3 inches long. When clamped to the fence, you can touch leg number 1 to the blade and adjust your fence scale to read 3 inches. And as if that wasn't enough, you can also use the Dado stop as a cross-cutting spacer. Since we know that the fixed leg of the Dado stop is exactly 3 inches long, just add 3 inches to the measurement you want to cut when setting the fence. Setup gauge. The setup gauge was originally created as an accessory for the dado stop. It records a template of the blade's exact kerf, making the dado stop setup faster and more accurate. Because the setup gauge is molded out of plastic, it retains its shape despite seasonal temperature and humidity changes. When you cut it, the setup gauge becomes a permanent, precise template of the kerf cut by that specific blade on that specific saw. The dado stop is used with a miter gauge for cross-cut dados. However, by accounting for the blade kerf and registering off the actual inlay material, we recently discovered that it can be used to cut long dados with the rip fence based on the same principle. Here's how you can cut long dados using the fence instead of short cross-cut dados with a miter gauge. Trim the kerf out of the left side of the setup gauge instead of the right side where it would normally be cut. Put a scrap piece of the inlay material against the fence crossbar with the trimmed section of the setup gauge touching the other side, and clamp the setup gauge to the fence rail. Cut the first shoulder of your dado. Move your fence so that it's touching the untrimmed portion of the setup gauge. Then cut the other shoulder, then trim out the middle in a few passes. Booyah! The setup gauge also features two notches to help cut dovetail tracks more quickly and accurately. This inner notch right here helps you quickly set your blade or router bit to a cutting depth of 11/32nds of an inch. And this outer notch right here serves as a depth gauge for your dovetail router bit. The MATCHFIT dovetail router bit has a laser cut depth guide for setting cutting depth, but if you're using a dovetail bit from any other brand, this notch makes setting your cutting depth much faster and more accurate. Quarter inch relief bit. The MATCHFIT quarter inch relief router bit is used to create a quarter inch wide, 11/32nds of an inch deep relief groove prior to cutting dovetail tracks. Cutting a quarter inch wide relief groove at this depth removes 55% of the waste material, putting less stress on and extending the lifespan of your dovetail router bit. Unlike any other quarter inch diameter router bit, this one features a 1/32nd inch roundover at the top of the profile. This roundover follows the profile of the MATCHFIT dovetail router bit, ensuring proportional material removal. It's also helpful for reducing fuzz and tear out at the top of the tracks when using a Dovetail router bit from another manufacturer. However small it may seem, those fibers can create an uneven surface, resulting in a depth variance when cutting Dovetail tracks. It also features a 3-degree upshear carbide. When used in conjunction with the MATCHFIT Dovetail router bit's downshear carbide, the alternating cutting direction yields noticeably cleaner cuts. Now let's look at some use cases where the MATCHFIT system can improve your workflow on common day-to-day tasks. Use Dovetail hardware to set up stops and clamps to secure material on sleds. Route a couple Dovetail tracks and create a simple auxiliary drill press table. Use a spacer to secure material from a distance, leaving the top unobstructed for flattening, template routing, or CNC work. Use it on your miter saw bench to set up stops and secure material. You can use it to make a tall fence on your table saw. And of course, assembling your projects on a flat surface will give you better overall results every time. Well, that's all I have for you today. Hopefully this has given you a better understanding of what the MATCHFIT system is, how it works, and how it can help you work smarter in your workshop. Thanks for watching.